May 2017, General Motors announced that it is leaving India as a part of its global restructuring strategy. September 2020, Harley-Davidson announced that it is going to close its operations in India as a part of its rewire strategy. September 2021, Ford Motors announced its exit from India after its losses crossed $2 billion. And Toyota announced that it will not make any further investments in Indian market. All these companies fail to create a solid customer base and gain the market share required to sustain in Indian market. But why? Why foreign automakers, especially American companies, are failing in India? Why Indian four-wheeler market is hard to navigate and what it takes to succeed in India? We will answer all these questions in today's episode. Over the last 20 years, Indian auto market has grown exponentially. India is the fifth largest automaker with 35 lakh passenger and commercial vehicles sold in 2020 alone. If we look at the segment-wise bifurcation, two-wheelers dominate the market. Of all the vehicles sold in 2020, 81% are two-wheelers and only 13% are passenger vehicles. Majority of Indians don't own a car and we have a growing majority of middle class and we are moving towards rapid urbanization, which gives a huge potential for growth, and Indian car market is expected to grow at a rate of 6% over the next few years. Any car maker would want to be part of this growth and sell as many cars as possible. But India is unlike any other market. It's not an easy nut to crack. You see, Indian market is highly concentrated in the hands of two players. Maruti Suzuki controls 50% of the market and the second largest player Hyundai controls 17.5%. Other players are in single digits. Maruti Suzuki and Hyundai combinedly control 67.5% of the market. And to really understand why American automakers are failing in India, we have to understand why Maruti Suzuki and Hyundai are successful. Maruti Suzuki started its operations in 1981, even before the liberalization. Here, Maruti Suzuki had the first mover advantage. But what made the company market leader is its strategy of making the budget-friendly cars. The majority of the Maruti cars are small hatchbacks and they are very much affordable. Even the maintenance and servicing costs are very low. Plus, they give a good mileage and have better resale value. Maruti has India's largest distribution network with around 3,600 outlets in 1,900 cities. This helps the company to sell cars easily to customers, thereby increasing their revenues. Hyundai entered the market in 1996. Hyundai knew that it couldn't beat Maruti in terms of price, so it adapted a different strategy. The company released cars with extra comfort and more features. The strategy still holds strong after 25 years. Hyundai is known for packaging innovative technologies in its cars. Many segment-first features like keyless entry and auto headlamps were debuted on Hyundai cars. Another thing that makes Hyundai a massive popular brand is its emphasis on designing attractive and eye-catching cars. Time and again, Hyundai has outdone itself by bringing extremely stylish and modern vehicles to India. Hyundai cars are attractive, fuel-efficient, have better resale value and give a good mileage. It has all the features that Indian consumers emphasize on before buying a car. Hyundai currently has 1,255 dealers across 748 cities in India. The most important success secret among Maruti and Hyundai is the vast variety of cars. They offer from hatchbacks to SUVs. Hyundai currently offers different variants of 13 vehicles and Maruti offers 16 vehicles across various categories. So based on the success story of Hyundai and Maruti Suzuki, we can understand the secret sauce for success in Indian car market. Produce small cars and they should be affordable. It should give a good mileage and have a better resale value. Have service center nearby customer. Cost of service and spare parts should be low and provide a wide range of cars to choose from. Rajiv Chabha, who is the president and managing director of MG Motors India, says that in India, very few players have been successful, but those who have succeeded are making good money. The name of the game in India, what he calls as R2R model. You look at the whole value chain from raw material to resale, and then at every stage, you have to see how you can reduce the cost. Maruti and Hyundai have done just that, and other foreign players fail to do. Scale is the secret for success in India. You see, Ford and General Motors were not selling luxury cars. They were selling mass market cars. When you're targeting the mass market, reach plays a crucial role. The availability of showroom and service center nearby can be the difference between someone buying and not buying a car. Maruti currently has over 3,500 service stations across India, while Hyundai has more than 1,300 in the country. In fact, within the 2 years of its entry into Indian market, South Korean firm Kia managed to have 125 service centers. However, even after 2 decades, Ford has only 383 service centers. Then why would someone drive long distances to get their car serviced when other brands are serving them nearby? India is predominantly a small car market. 7 out of every 10 cars sold in India come from this segment. Even Indian tax laws are in favor of small cars. For example, cars less than 4 meters in length and engines up to 1.2 liters attract a duty of 29%. Whereas, if the car is larger, then companies have to pay up to 50% as taxes. Indians love the word value for money. In a price-sensitive market like India, companies have to produce cars that are cost-effective and provide a lot of features. This is where the foreign players are failing. The cheapest passenger car Maruti offers in India has a starting price of 3,15,000 rupees, while Ford's equivalent costs more than 5 lakh rupees. Obviously, the customers will choose Maruti. Foreign car makers, especially American companies, are experts in making big cars, but when they try to make a small car, their expertise is not helping them. One of the most important factors is leadership. Because top management is responsible for all the decision making, their understanding of Indian market plays a crucial role. Both GM and Ford follow a centralized decision making, which happens from headquarters in US and other regional offices that don't really have a clear understanding of ground realities in the Indian market. Their decision was meant to fail. They are not good with the local leadership either. India is a complex country and has a unique mix of Asian and Western values. Understanding it takes time and focus. Having a stable leadership is very important. But General Motors had 9 different people lead its Indian business in the last 21 years. They lacked an India-focused strategy, and by the time they realized its importance, it was quite late and Asian rivals such as Hyundai had surged into the market. To succeed in India, companies have to make cars that are Indian. You see, Indian car market is divided into 2 segments, urban and rural. They both have different expectations from the car, and the companies that work towards meeting their expectations will succeed in India. You cannot take a successful American car and release the same in India hoping that it will be successful. General Motors seems to be the worst offender among all the American companies. Cars like Chevrolet Sail, Captiva, Opel Astra, Corsa, Vectra are examples of this. When American companies do get down and make an India-first product, they did see some success. For example, Ford EcoSport, Icon, Indian Fiesta, Chevrolet Beat. See, these are not the most successful cars, but they at least came close to meeting Indian taste. Ford and GM could have replicated the same, but they were not consistent. They were not coming up with new models. Ford entered a joint venture with Mahindra & Mahindra in 2019, which collapsed on 31st December 2020. This backfired quite significantly and left Ford with no new models for near future, and its plants were underutilized. In the compact and subcompact SUV segment, except for EcoSport, which is almost 9 years old now, Ford still don't have a car that can take on Creta and Seltos. Even General Motors faced difficulties. In the last 20 years, they have introduced about 20 models, of which 10 were withdrawn. The price tags ranged from 3 lakhs to 30 lakhs. Frequent launches and withdrawal of models demotivates customers who own such models. GM sold over 1 million units during its existence in India. While in last 33 years, Maruti had also launched about 20 models and sold 13 million units. The back beating that Ford took in India is not isolated. Earlier in January this year, it closed its operations in Brazil, putting an end to the decades of manufacturing presence in that country. General Motors is also exiting Australia, New Zealand, and Thailand to save cost in underperforming markets. You see, there are many company-specific reasons as well. GM almost went bankrupt during 2008 crisis. It is still trying to recover from that. Ford is seeing slowdown its sales worldwide. Indian market is not just difficult for American companies. Other players like Toyota, Volkswagen, Renault, Nissan and Honda have mostly remained small players in Indian car market. You see, Maruti and Hyundai have a really good brand presence. From rural to urban India, everyone recognizes these brands. We Indians ask our relatives, friends and neighbors before buying a car, who most probably own Maruti or Hyundai car. And most likely, their advice will be to buy one of these two. Now, even if a company tries to compete, it is most likely to fail unless one of these companies stop making good cars. See, it is clear that Indian car market is not for everyone. The common use of English language and the fact that there are so many people of Indian origin integrated into US society gives a false sense of security to companies when doing business in India. But Indians are very different. Their socio-economic reality is very different. Their cultural reality is very different. This is a huge barrier. Indian market is difficult but not impossible. Where Western companies are struggling to make their mark, surprisingly, Asian companies control 67% of the market. Exit from India may not be a negative thing. Sometimes strategies fail and new strategies emerge. GM and Ford are now planning to invest aggressively in electric vehicles. From their point of view, making an investment in EVs is more fruitful than investing in Indian market. GM and Ford left India, but they left some valuable lessons for the future automakers aspiring to enter India. So that's the video, guys. What do you think? Can any foreign car maker succeed in India? If yes, which brand? Let me know in the comments below. See you in the next one.